A failure of COVID protocols at Fiona Stanley Hospital has exposed patients and staff to Omicron. It comes as the number of local infections today jumped to 24, with the government admitting there's now no chance of eliminating the virus.
As Omicron cases begin to surge, one of Perth's major hospitals has fallen at the first hurdle.
It may well be a bit of a wake-up call for those staff working on the front line that we really do have COVID in our community now, that this isn't a practice run, that this is for real.
A mother and her sick child, both COVID positive, were incorrectly directed to the emergency department waiting room by a screening nurse outside Fiona Stanley Hospital.
The hospital has strict procedures in place for suspect COVID-19 patients, but unfortunately these were not followed.
Even after the mother questioned the advice, the nurse insisted the pair enter the general ED instead of a secure area. Now five other families and a number of staff are in isolation.
But it wasn't a nurse, it was an assistant in nursing, and the problem was they were relieving and they hadn't been given all the information.
The opposition's slammed the bungle as embarrassing.
It's shocking to see the McGowan government bungle another set of basic COVID protocols.
Masks were worn the whole time, but this is being taken extremely seriously.
It comes as WA recorded 24 new local cases today, Westfield Carousel among new exposure sites. The state now has 90 active cases.
I think it's clear that we're not going to eliminate Omicron. It's now about how we suppress and manage Omicron.
Despite Omicron beginning to surge through the community and with exposure sites now in their hundreds, testing clinics remain quiet. Less than 5,000 people were tested yesterday. The Health Minister is pleading to anyone with symptoms to come forward. While the government confirmed it's chartering flights to travel overseas to secure rapid antigen tests.
And we have ordered 80 million, and we're certainly looking at how we can get those into Western Australia as quickly as possible.
The lingering virus leading nurses to call for the Australia Day Skyworks to be cancelled.
I'm not quite sure how many cases we have to have before they stop, you know, 250,000 people gathering on the foreshores of Perth on Wednesday night.
Jessica Brown for 10 News First.